Welcome into the BSC Sports Show. I'm Landrum Roberts. On this month's show, we sit down with head football coach Eddy Garfinkle and recap the 2015 regular season. Then later on, we'll have a chat with new Birmingham Southern College President Dr. Ed Leonard. All of that coming your way next, right here on the BSC Sports Show. Samir gets away from one man. He's got his first down. Samir inside the 10, 5, leaps across the goal line. Touchdown, Panthers. BSC Sports Show is being brought to you by Alabama Power, always on. America's First Federal Credit Union, refreshingly unbank-like. Chick-fil-A in Fultondale, home of the original chicken sandwich. Dreamland Barbecue, ain't nothing like them nowhere. The Greater Birmingham Convention and Visitors Bureau. Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers. If we don't take care of our customers, someone else will. Limbaugh Toyota, home of the lifetime powertrain warranty. Pepsi, out of the blue. Piggly Wiggly, we'll see you at the pig. St. Vincent's Health System, care you can believe in. And by Summit Express Urgent Care, at the summit of urgent care.
Hi, my name is Jamal Watkins, receiver number 8. I'm originally from Hampton, Georgia, but I transferred from Dodge City Community College out in Kansas. Out of high school, I went to Mississippi State, walked on, redshirted there my first year. Things wasn't working out. I wasn't happy, so I decided to go JUCO, try to pick up another D1 offer, see if I could get any looks. I ended up spraining my MCL, so as far as looks, a lot of schools passed up on me. I contacted staff here. They gave me a shot, came down. Got accepted, everything. Got here, they showed me a lot of love, and I fell in love with the program.
All right, they're going to try Watkins again. He's already got a 92-yarder. Watkins, still on his feet. Here goes Watkins. Watkins, down the sideline. No flags. He's done it again. 93 yards. Touchdown, Panthers. Oh my goodness! Lightning strikes twice and the Panthers respond!
When the ball is being kicked to me, I really just trust in what we set up. Coach put us in a good position. Really, I just hit the holes. I know if I break, I got the speed, but really, I know if we do something good, I'm looking to take the momentum or keep it, either way. When I first got here, I was working out in the summer a lot with Mickey. We built the chemistry, I liked him, he's smart. He's out from Texas, so we connected real good. He's thrown to a lot of fast guys. And then when the season kicked off, Austin came in. And whenever coach is feeling towards one of the guys, you know, he swaps them in. So in practice, we do it a lot. So I'm really familiar with both of the guys. They can make all the throws. They're both very smart. So really it's just up to me to do what I do in practice. The atmosphere is amazing. You know everyone personally here. You know, it could be your teachers here, friends, family. I'm close to Georgia, so a lot of family can make it out. I like the atmosphere because it's like right after the game, everyone waits for you to get out of the locker room and just congratulates you. Pretty much everybody knows you personally, so it's like you're not just a face of them, you're a friend. So I like that, having that connection with everyone.
Welcome back to the BSC Sports Show. Landrum Roberts now being joined by Birmingham Southern head football coach Eddy Garfinkle. Coach, as we put a bow on 2015 in the regular season, your team finishes 5-5, 4-1 right here on this very field. How did it make you feel good playing in front of the home folks and playing well all season?
Yeah, you know, we had a fun team to coach. Guys kind of bought into what we were doing and overall went out there and gave great effort every game. We played well at home. That's one thing that we've got to get better at is being able to play, you know, well on the road. But overall, as young as we were and inexperienced, we had some guys really fill in and do a really good job. So, like I said, they're a fun team to coach and a fun team to watch.
Well, one of those games, Huntington, we talked about it the last time that you were with us, but one of the most exciting games I've ever seen. Of course, Jamal Watkins, the two big, long touchdown runs on special teams, and just the back and forth there in the final minute. What an exciting night.
Yeah, that was an exciting game. You know, it was interesting after the game, Coach Turk, the head coach, said this might be the best thing that ever happened to us because they felt like they had a really good team. They didn't play their best, and they got their attention, and of course, they went on and won the rest of their games and lost in the second round of the playoffs. So it was a quality football team that we beat. And again, just proud of our guys, the way they give great effort, and we just got to continue to get better.
Your team followed that up with a big win over Swanee. I said at the time I thought it was one of the most complete games that your team had played for four quarters over the past few years, and you didn't disappoint against the Tigers.
Right. You know, we played that was a good, great team effort. The offense and the defense kicking teams all clicked together. Defensively, we played well. And again, that was a big win for us because we've struggled with Swanee over the last couple of years, so we needed that win.
Well, homecoming 2015, always a special time here on the Hilltop. Very special day indeed, as a lot of the Birmingham Southern folks, they came back to enjoy a great day of football and also a very special honor as the stadium officially named General Charles C. Krulak Stadium, Birmingham Southern's 13th president. And what a special day for that gentleman, and well deserved.
Yeah, you know, General Krulak has been such a influence and great thing for Birmingham Southern. He's brought us back, you know, kind of, I guess, to a level playing field sort of with the college, and what a great honor that was. I know he was completely surprised by it. Homecoming's a special day, always a big crowd. We had come off some tough losses, and so we needed to really win, and we needed to play well, and we did. We go into the game, we emphasize the fact against Millsaps the last 5 years, a team that protected the football and ran the football, was a team that became on were the winners, and that's what we did. So our guys did a really good job of executing our plan, and that was a good day.
Got off to the quick start there in the first half, and then the defense gave up a couple of touchdowns. It was 12-12 there for a while, but your team ended up running away, forcing four turnovers, and your team did not cough it up once.
Right, that was the big thing, you know, protecting the football. We gave up some big plays defensively. That's kind of been our Achilles heel a lot during the year, where we're playing good defense and all of a sudden, you know, it's a long touchdown run, a touchdown pass. But we were able to overcome it. Defense kind of played solid the rest of the game and did, you know, get some turnovers, you know, several interceptions and that type of thing.
Yeah, and you couldn't have scripted it any better, and give credit to your offensive coordinator, Joe White. You possessed the ball for 40 minutes anytime. You forced four turnovers, possessed the ball more than the other team as far as time of possession. You got to like your chances.
Right, and that's the big thing. You know, that's our winning formula is run the football, possess the football, protect the football, and then, you know, don't give up big plays on defense, and we can win. The times that we've done that consistently is the times that we've won football games.
A bit of a breakout for one of your tailbacks, Justin Woolfolk, had the 55-yard touchdown there, and of course, Samir Usman, the junior, he was the workhorse that day, carrying it 30 times for 133 yards and a touchdown.
Yes, Samir is a tough runner, and, you know, we like to play two tailbacks, and Justin rotated in with him. And so that 1-2 punch worked out well against Millsaps on that day.
Your junior quarterback, Austin Martin, 21 of 25 that day for 234 yards, two touchdowns, both coming to your talented newcomer, sophomore Jamal Watkins.
Right, Austin, of course, real proud of Austin. You know, he kind of lost his position as a sophomore and won it back this year. And he worked hard and really improved throughout the year and did some good things. And Jamal Watkins, what a great addition for us. He's got a lot of speed, great young man, plays hard, and we're looking forward to having him for a couple more years.
As a defensive coordinator, I know you love the Trevor Dedecker scoop and score, 28 yards, really seemed to pick the team up at the right time.
Yeah, that was a big time play. You know, he had a quarterback sack, a cause fumble, a fumble recovery, and a touchdown. You know, when we grade our film, we give guys production points. I think that was like a 21-22 production point play. So that was a big play in the ball game for us.
Coach, the other three turnovers that we talked about, all interceptions, two coming from your secondary, and then one uncharacteristically coming from your defensive lineman.
Yeah, Matthew Gibbs, I think we batted a pass, and they're trying to run a screen or something, and he made a good play. And then our secondary has done well all year in making plays when we needed to, especially on interceptions.
Yeah, Matthew Gibbs, of course, the interception there. Preston Hooper and Gavin Summerall, they got it done there in the secondary.
Right, yeah, like I said, those are Gavin and Matthew, of course, a freshman. Gavin's a sophomore, was a quarterback. We moved to defensive back, and he did a good job this year for us. So we're looking forward to all our guys in the secondary coming back.
So the Panthers knock off Millsaps 35-18, and then your final game, your regular season finale right here at Panther Stadium. Ominous morning. Weird circumstances. The Barry Vikings came in. They had lost one game all season. They were undefeated in Southern Athletic Association play. You knew that it was going to be a challenge, but if it wasn't challenge enough, well, we lost power here on campus, and we did not have use of a clock. Made things a little chaotic there in the press box for us. I know it did for you guys down on the field.
Yeah, you know, in the locker room before the game, getting dressed in tape. You know, our guys handle it well. And we had a bunch of recruits in, and that was kind of, we were a little apologetic, but everybody understood there's nothing you really can do about it. And then, so, you know, we didn't allow that to be a distraction. And real proud of the way our guys, competed and really came back, because right off of a couple of disappointing losses again, and we needed to finish the season strong and beat a good football team, which we did against Barry. We tried to tell our guys we had a good football team, and I don't think they believed it. And we're just, you know, we're close, and just a few plays here their way. And so that gave us a good feeling. That was a good victory for send the seniors out the right way and to gain momentum for the young guys that are coming back for the 2016 season.
You jumped out to the early lead, got up 14-0, really no looking back. I thought Austin Martin, your quarterback, was efficient, 10 of 13. You didn't ask a whole lot from him, but when you did ask him, he delivered 89 yards, and the rest, it was just defense and good old-fashioned football.
Yeah, you know, our defense did a really good job, and you know, that was Barry's success. They would win games 14-7, 21-14, and so we knew that, you know, we were gonna struggle to score a lot of points against them. So we knew defensively we had to really hold them under what they've been doing. So our defensive guys did a really good job of executing, and we gave them opportunities at the end, which was kind of nerve-wracking, but we came through and stopped them at the end.
Coach, as we look at 2015 as a whole, the entire season, I think one thing that was very encouraging, of course, you had a talented group of seniors that we'll hate to see go, but a lot of juniors, sophomore, even freshmen that got significant playing time and really made significant contributions.
Yes, you know, this was a young team. I think we dressed and played 20 freshmen, which was the most we ever had. I know when we won the conference in 2012, we had one freshman that dressed out. So we did have a young team. Real proud of our seniors. You know, we lost some good players off that senior class, but a lot of them, it was their first time playing and first time starting. And they really came through and really, you know, proud about those guys hanging in there and their leadership that they displayed, and the young guys just seemed to follow along with them. So, you know, if we can kind of hold the core together, we got a chance in 2016.
Well, special recognition to one of those players, those seniors, your linebacker. He was all over the field all season long, and that was number 5, Alex King.
Yeah. Alex King had a great year. He had backed up Austin Martin. Austin Hansard for a couple years, you know, and was really a standout on special teams, but it was his opportunity. He took great advantage of it. I thought he was the defensive player of the year of the conference, and he probably was right there close to the vote, second place, I would think. But he had a fantastic year and you know, really did some really good things as far as leadership-wise also.
Yeah, Alex King, the senior from Mobile. Of course, first team all-conference, 98 total tackles, 57 of them tackles for a loss, and he finished fourth in the conference with 5.5 sacks. So a great year for Alex King.
Yeah, he did, and he had, I think, several fumble recoveries. And so, you know, that's what we needed. We needed the guys to come through for us, and he was one of them.
Well, no surprise, your sophomore, Jamal Watkins, he is named Special Teams Player of the Year. I don't think there was any argument for any coaches around the conference that saw that young man play.
Yeah, you know, not only was he effective returning kickoffs, and of course people quit kicking to him, you know, after a while, and punts, you know, he became our return man, but he also covered punts on our punt team. He was one of our gunners, and he ran down there and made people fair catch it very often, and that was very valuable. So he did a great job on special teams, and that was like I said, a great addition to our team this year.
Also, a couple of other guys that were named. Nick Maxey, one of your offensive linemen. They don't get a whole lot of credit, but he was named to the second team all-conference.
Yeah, Nick had a really good year. You know, he struggled with injuries for a couple years, and he's been pretty consistent, a starter for several years, and he had his best year. And I'm not surprised. I'm glad he stayed relatively healthy. He fought through injuries the entire year. What a great young man, very tough physically and mentally, and he had his best year you know, for us as a Panther.
Also named to the Southern Athletic Association All-Conference second team, Samir Usman, your tailback, who we've talked about, and Matt Franks, your talented junior defensive back.
You know, Samir, this was his kind of first year we featured him, and he did a really good job. I think, you know, we're looking forward to having him back, and Matt Franks is a guy that, you know, is his first opportunity to play and start. And, you know, he did some really, really good thing. He was one of the leaders on the defense. He, you know, the free safety's got to get you lined up, make the checks. And he's such a cerebral player. You know, he knows what to do. And that was big for us this year. So he, as well deserving for him.
Honorable mention, a couple guys we need to mention. And that would be Matthew Byers, a freshman. I mean, that's great to make that kind of statement your freshman season. And, of course, your senior punter, Hagan Mancuso.
Right. You know, Matthew was a guy that we recruited from John Carroll. He was a receiver, defensive back. And we said, hey, Matthew, we need some corners. And he said, Coach, I'll play wherever. And, you know, we found out early he was a football player. You know, he's not real big in stature, but just had a great knack for the ball. And you know, he wound up starting and making an honorable mention. And Hagan Mancuso had a really good year. We had some good punters in our league. Hagan had his best year. I think every week we met our goal of punting, averaging 38 yards net punting. And then, of course, he had some good kicks where we downed it inside the 10-yard line as well.
Well, when I saw that he made honorable mention, I'm trying to sit there and rack my brain and go, who punted the ball better than Hagan this year? Because you're right, he saved his best for last. Right. Outstanding job, and he meant so much as far as field position for your team.
Yeah, he really did. And, you know, like I said, there were several good punters, and I think average-wise, maybe he wasn't right there, but I think that was deceptive because he did, you know, have some good punts inside the 20-yard line consistently the entire year.
So you finished 5-5 overall, right there in the middle of the pack of the Southern Athletic Association. So nothing to be ashamed with. A lot of experience coming back. So let's look ahead to 2016. You know, it's going to be challenging, and I guess right now, really, it's recruiting never stops at Division III.
Right. You know, of course, right now we're focusing on recruiting, and we'll get our players back, you know, in January. We have an exploratory one-month January turn, so I say half the team will be there working out and the other half will be home on their own, and then, you know, we'll start preparing for February. You know, the core of our team will be the guys that are returning from this year's team, and we've got some good young guys that we're excited about. We certainly have a lot of holes to fill, especially in the line of scrimmage, and we've got to have the same thing. We have guys that have been in the program for a few years, and now it's their turn. They're upperclassmen, juniors and seniors, and they've got to step in and do the job and improve, and we will, because we've had really good leadership, good team chemistry. We tell our guys, you know, the life of a team lasts 1 year, and the 2015 team, we were trying to get the momentum back and get it going like we had for a while, which we had lost after the 2014 team. And so we got to keep that momentum going and building, and a lot has to do with team chemistry. And I think right now we're in good shape with some good leaders.
Well, congratulations on finishing strong against the Barry Vikings with a 14-7 win right here in Krulak Stadium on Battlefield. And congratulations and good luck next year.
Okay, appreciate it. Thank you all, Landrum. Y'all do a great job.
Thanks, Coach. All right, the BSC Sports Show continues after this.
Hey, I'm Alex King from Birmingham Southern, number 5, senior linebacker. I'm from Mobile, Alabama, played high school at St. Paul's Episcopal School. Coach G, Coach Garfinkle, man, he doesn't let us get away with anything. He demands perfection. If you played okay on a play, he's going to be on you. You have to be perfect. He demands perfection. Any little mess up in our defense, he's going to get on to you. He demands perfection. You're not going to get a good job for playing good. You got to play great to get his attention out there. I'm a senior business major looking to go into healthcare administration. Really just being in the city of Birmingham opens a lot of opportunities. We got such a healthcare-centered based city. I want to go to grad school at UAB. They have the number 2 program in the nation. So Birmingham Southern just really opened the doors for that. And being a business major, I already know all the management, accountings, everything I'll need to know besides the healthcare side. So it's really been a big advantage for me to go to such a great school. And just the liberal arts education, where I have such a diverse background, I can really go into anything I need healthcare-wise. We try to force turnovers anytime we're on the field. Our guys up front do a great job to free up our linebackers. And then I can't brag on our secondary enough. They allow us to play man coverage almost all the time, so we can stack the box. And then people may be able to dink and dunk the ball down the field a little bit, but you know, at the end of the day, we know they're going to cause turnovers. You know, they can't beat us with a little gain all game. And you know, you see that. Matthew Byers had a big interception today. I think on fourth down we had a strip sack and returned that for a touchdown. Basically, our defense has been doing a great job all year on forcing turnovers and scoring touchdowns.
Welcome back to the BSC Sports Show. Landrum Roberts now being joined by the 14th president in the history of Birmingham Southern College, Dr. Ed Leonard. First of all, Dr. Leonard, welcome to Birmingham Southern. I know that you've been around for a while, but I'd like to officially welcome you.
Well, thank you.
And thanks for taking the time to join us.
Oh, happy to do it.
Dr. Leonard, first of all, you came from Bethany College, Lenzburg, Kansas, a far cry from Birmingham, Alabama. What drew you to BSC?
Well, BSC is a college I've known for almost 35 years. It's a college I've visited a couple of times over the years. Known some folks who have worked at Birmingham Southern. And so when the general announced his retirement, certainly that landed on the radar screen, and then got a phone call from the search firm and had a conversation, and went home that night and asked my wife, who is from New Orleans, would she at all be interested in moving back south? And I don't think a heartbeat went by, and it was a resounding go for it. So the big advantage was we're 5 hours from New Orleans versus 15 hours from New Orleans. But you know, it's a great school that took a sucker punch, and we're excited to be here and get things back on track and to finish the job the general started.
So Dr. Leonard, you mentioned the general and General Krulak, and what a job he did turning this institution around, getting it back on solid ground in the 4 years that he was here. What is Dr. Ed Leonard's vision for this institution, not only in 2016, but beyond?
Well, you know, that's always a great question. I think it would be a bit presumptuous, even though I've been here for 5 months, to really lay out exactly what that looks like. Certainly want to get BSC back to where it was and past that point. And so we're actually going through the process this year of spending a lot of time listening and understanding who best BSC is and you know what is it in its DNA. And then hopefully the plan is by the end of the academic year to really lay out what the vision of the future would look like, and not a few years out, but probably, you know, give or take 15 years out, something that really overarches a lot of us and really will inspire us to chase that future.
Talking about General Krulak, how much have you leaned on him as far as the transition, taking over as the president of Birmingham Southern College?
I would say my two biggest advisors and cheerleaders are General Krulak and Neil Birdie. By either by phone, by email, or in person, I touch them at least, each of them at least once a week. And you know, a lot of people have asked, what's it like to follow, you know, in the footsteps, or what's it like to be in the shadow of those two Birmingham Southern Giants? And I just snicker and say, I'm not in their shadow, I'm standing on their shoulders. So they're great. I'm really excited to be working with them, and glad they still want to be part of what's going on.
Not only Birmingham Southern being such a fine academic institution, but also has a great history of athletic success and achievement. What do you see as a president as far as athletics? How do you see them complementing, the academic mission of this institution?
Sure. I would start off by saying I don't see the academic portion, the academic mission of BSC and athletics as being mutually exclusive. In fact, I see athletics as being very much a part of the academic mission. I was a swimmer in college, so I understand the value of that athletics brings to the undergraduate college experience. And so I think the answer is, how do we make it seamless? How do we really get those two to give the best possible experience in someone's 4 years at BSC? You know, I will say that I probably learned as much in the swimming pool in 4 years as I did in the classroom. It was a different kind of learning, but it was certainly life lessons. It was a laboratory and experiences that I've taken with me my whole life. So I to me, they're linked.
So I guess it's safe to say, let's say in a couple months when the swimming and diving team wins another conference championship,
that's the expectation.
You will be taking the plunge as in the pool.
Well, you know, I'm an old-fashioned swim guy, and you don't jump in; you get thrown in. So I'm not saying anything, but I'm not jumping in. I'm not that silly.
Your first game, home football game.
Right.
It was a night game against Huntington.
Yeah.
The Wesley Cup.
And it was a week after the LaGrange game.
Yeah, you went on the road. You went on the road. You traveled to LaGrange. First of all, a week one thriller over there where Birmingham Southern comes back in the final minutes to claim the win. Then we come home and play Huntington. It's now traditionally across the conference here. Your first night game or your first game at home. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we kick it off at 6 o'clock under the lights. People get excited. I can't remember a more exciting game here on the Hilltop than that one against Huntington College that night.
You know, obviously I've only seen six football games, BSC football games, but I come from a storied football tradition, both where I went to college and the colleges where I've worked over the years. So it was really fun, and I felt right back at home. You know, I told the coaches after the LaGrange game that was it for, my heart couldn't take anymore. And then they decide they're gonna up the ante going from LaGrange to Huntington. And in fact, I was talking to a football recruit here recently about how many football games, any level of college football, where 20 points are scored in 50 seconds, you know. And you know, we could have easily gone into overtime, and I'm happy Huntington decided to put it all on the line, and I'm glad the defense stepped up and knocked the ball down, and they didn't get the two-point conversion.
Well, not to mention that, and you mentioned all the points in the final minute, but two kickoff returns for touchdowns by Jamal Watkins,
yeah,
the sophomore.
Jamal's both of those, and if I remember correctly, I'm not sure he got the ball the rest of the season on any kickoff,
but they
learned very quickly. And of course, I also point out Huntington had an outstanding season this year. Unfortunately, in the regular season, they only had one loss, us.
Homecoming versus Millsaps, a very special day. General Krulak has a stadium named after him. The unveiling, obviously, he got emotional. I saw you there, and I knew I was going to like you before we had even met, because I saw you walking around with a great-looking pair of slacks on.
Yeah, you liked my yellow slacks.
Yellow, gold, whatever color you want to call those. I thought it made a statement about you, and I think you told me that you had to battle your wife Sheila
on
that one.
I did. I'd been eyeing those at, I think they were at Brooks Brothers at the Outlet Mall east of here, and she was reluctant in letting me buy them. She let me try them on. She said, all right, we'll go ahead and buy them, but don't take the price tag off. And we get to homecoming. I said, well, I want to wear these at homecoming. She said, well, why don't you go ahead and put them on? So, but anyway, she gave in, and I got to wear the yellow pants. And I was easy to spot.
It was a good look. It was a good
Well,
look.
Thank you. I appreciate
I've requested
that.
A pair
oh, you have.
From my wife for Christmas. So we'll see how that goes. Speaking of your family, Sheila, your wife, and your mm-hmm. two sons, of course, Quade and Thomas, mm-hmm. how's the transition been from them coming from Kansas?
Oh, I would say the transition has gone well. Obviously, for Sheila, being from New Orleans, you know, she loves being back in the South. She loves being back in grits land. I mean, when we go out for dinner, she has grits and shrimp. I mean, I can almost guarantee if it's on the menu, that's what she's going to have. For Thomas, who's in kindergarten, that was a very easy slam dunk. When I informed him that we were going to move, or we had the opportunity to move, we could continue to drive 70 miles to Chuck E. Cheese, or we could drive less than 10 miles to two Chuck E. Cheeses. So that won him over. I mean, he couldn't get here fast enough, and I think we've been two or three times already. Quade being in seventh grade, that transition I think also has gone better. But you know, middle school's a tough time to uproot. You know, he obviously misses his friends, and technology has allowed him to stay in touch. In fact, he spent an hour and a half on the phone and online playing some internet games with one of his buddies back in Kansas. But he's acclimating. The BSC students have been incredible this fall, particularly with Quade. You may have noticed he played with the marching band all fall. He didn't march with them, but they invited him to grab his saxophone and come play with them and send him the music. And so football for him went from, oh geez, Dad, do I have to go to another game, to, Dad, when's the next game?
Wonderful.
So he's, you know, so they're everybody's adjusting ahead of plan.
By the way, I know we're filming this show in December, and I will go ahead and let you know, Dr. Leonard, that the climate is probably better during the winter here, but typically not 75 degrees.
And well, just it's pretty nice now.
To make you feel better, though, I checked the weather in Lindsborg, and it's 39 and cloudy.
No, I wouldn't be surprised. That would be a typical December day.
Well, Dr. Leonard, thank you so much for taking the time for joining
us.
And happy holidays to you and your family.
Well, and to you as well.
Continued success. And
great.
Wonderful meeting you.
Thanks.
All right, that's Dr. Ed Leonard, the 14th president of Birmingham Southern College, and this is the BSC Sports Show. Well, that's going to do it for the 2015 edition of the BSC Sports Show. Special thanks to Birmingham Southern College President Dr. Ed Leonard, Athletics Director Joe Dean Jr., Associate Athletics Director Kendall Waters, and Sports Information Director Sarah Areca. From all of us here on the Hilltop to your family, Happy New Year. This edition of the BSC Sports Show has been brought to you by Alabama Power, always on, America's First Federal Credit Union, refreshingly unbanked life, Chick-fil-A in Fultondale, home of the original chicken sandwich, Dreamland Barbecue, ain't nothing like them nowhere, the Greater Birmingham Convention and Visitors Bureau, Express Oil Change and Tire Engineers, if we don't take care of our customers, someone else will, Limbaugh Toyota, home of the lifetime powertrain warranty, Pepsi,
out of the blue. Piggly Wiggly, we'll see you at the Pig. St. Vincent's Health System, care you can believe in. And by Summit Express Urgent Care, at the Summit of Urgent Care.